This is an ILI 9341 SPI LCD module, and ESP8266 is driving this module. I'm using the Adafruit ILI 9341 LCD library. From this video and onward, I am going to use this setup. This setup is pretty helpful because it eliminates the need to switch between UARTs to show the necessary information. This module can be purchased online for around $7. After googling a bit, I found this blog to be very helpful. First, go to the Adafruit repository. I have already opened it. Click clone or download. In this case, download the zip file. Then go to the download folder. Remember the location. So now open your Arduino. Go to edit, go to sketch, include library, add zip library. Now go to downloads, select the library and click open. You can see a message here, it says library added to your libraries. Now go to file, examples, figure out the Adafruit library and click on the graphics test. You need to change two things in here. It's like you have to change the DC to, it says here, DC to D1 and CS to D2. So change DC to D1 and CS to D2. Now check if everything compiles. Now let's move on to the wiring portion. Here is the diagram. For connecting the display to the development board, we will need some DuPont cable. I have taken out 9 pieces of them. Let's connect the DuPont cables with the LCD. Now scroll down a bit and you will see the connection diagram. So first of all, we need to connect the VCC to 3.3 volt. VCC is the ground cable. Let's connect it to 3.3 volt. Then the red wire, that is ground. Then the CS pin, we need to connect CS pin to D2. Then reset pin, we need to connect the reset pin to, there are a couple of 3.3 volts output there, so we need to connect to one of them. So I'm connecting to this pin. Oops. Then there is DC/RS that should be connected to D1. The blue pin is SDI/MOSI that should be connected to D7. Now connect SCK to D5. SCK is this cable to D5. Then there is the violet cable, that is to 3.3 volt. Violet cable to 3.3 volt. Then there is the white cable, that is SDA or MISO, that should be connected to this 6. Have already programmed the development board, so let's see the chip in action. Alright, this works. This wraps up the today's video. From next one, I'm going to use this setup. Thanks for watching.